Hello everyone, and welcome to Vector in Motion. Today we are going to learn about method of sections for carrying out truss analysis. We use method of sections when we want to figure out internal force in only one member or just a few members, and when we want to find out internal forces in all the members, then method of joints is a preferred method. Here in this truss, we want to figure out the force in members CE, DE and DF. So we shall use method of sections. So let's look into the steps involved in this method of sections. The first step is to draw a FBD of the entire truss. And here is the FBD of the truss. These two components of a force replace the pin support at point A and force IY in place of roller support. And the first task is to determine these three forces. So we have the three equilibrium equations. The first one, sigma Fx equal to 0, gives Ax equal to 0. That is the only force in horizontal or x direction. And next we take moment, all the forces about I. And we get this expression. Ay produces clockwise moment, therefore it is minus. These are the moments of the applied forces at B, D, F, G. And this force does not contribute any moment. And therefore, we get Ay equal to 4 kilonewtons. And from the equation sigma Fy equal to 0, we get Iy equal to 4 kilonewtons. So the support reactions are Ax is 0, these two forces, Ay and Iy, are 4 kilonewtons each. Next, we pass a section through maximum 3 members of the truss, and the desired member should be one of them. So here we want to find out the internal force in members CE, DE and DF. So we should pass a section like this, which divides the entire truss into two parts. This section cuts the members CE, DE and DF. And when we cut these members, we expose the internal forces of the members DF, DE and CE. And next, we draw a BD of any of the portion. Typically, we choose a portion which has less number of forces so that our calculation work will be limited. This diagram shows the two parts. The forces in these three members are exposed and they look like this. We assume that these forces are tensile forces and therefore they act away from the pins D and C as well as F and E. We can carry out the analysis of any of these two parts, but just to reduce our calculation time, we'll select a part which has least number of forces. Here in this case, we should be taking the left side and carry out the equilibrium analysis. The result would work out to be the same regardless of which portion we take up for our analysis. So this is the left part of the truss which we obtain when we pass a section like this. This diagram is a little magnified so that we can clearly see the direction of the various forces. Note that forces FDF, FDE and FCE are now the external forces for this system. This is the reaction force Ay. This is the external load, which is here. This is the external load of 2 kilonewtons at point D. We want to figure out the magnitude of these forces. We already know the direction because all these members are two force members, and therefore all these would be axial forces along the direction of the members. So we need to just find out the magnitude of these three. The direction is known. And now you can see that these forces are a system of non-concurrent forces. So we have three equilibrium equations. Recall that in method of joints, we had two equations for each of the pin because we were dealing with concurrent forces. But here we are dealing with non-concurrent forces, and therefore we have three equations, two force equations in x and y direction, and one moment equation. Okay? So let us first take a moment about point E. And when we do that, these two unknowns, FDE and FCE, get eliminated. And we'll have an equation which will have only one unknown, FDF. So from that equation, we'll be able to get the value of FDF straight away. Let us first find out the slope of these two unknown forces. We notice that the vertical bars are separated from each other by a distance of 2.4 meters. The length of this bar is 2.62, and that of this shortest bar is 0.46. So from simple geometry, we can find out that this bar DC is of 1 meter length. That is, it is greater than AB by 0.54 meter, and therefore the slope of this force, FDF, is 0.54 over 2.4. 2.4 is the distance AC. Therefore, the hypotenuse of this right angle triangle would be 2.46. And coming to this force FDE, this is 1 meter, and the distance between CE is 2.4 meters. Therefore, the slope is 1 over 2.4. And therefore, the hypotenuse of this triangle is 2.6. We'll need the information of the slope when we compute moment of these two forces about certain points. So let us first compute the moment of all the forces about point E. The 4 kilonewton force here would produce a clockwise moment about point E, and the 1 kilonewton force would produce a anticlockwise moment. The moment arm for these two forces would be the distance AE, which is 2.4 plus 2.4, that is 4.8 meters. The moment of this force, 2 kilonewtons, will be anticlockwise, and the moment arm will be 2.4 meters. We can ignore these two forces, FDE and FCE, because they pass through point E and their moment would be zero. To compute moment of force FDF, we'll first resolve it into vertical and horizontal components. The vertical component would be FDF times 0.54 over 2.46, and the horizontal component would be pointing towards right, and its moment would be clockwise. The moment of the vertical component also would be clockwise. So now let us write the equation. The 4 kilonewton force produces a clockwise moment, therefore it is minus 4 times 4.8. The moment of 1 kilonewton is 1 times 4.8. That of 2 kilonewton force is 2 times 2.4. And this is the moment of the vertical component of FDF. FDF times 0.54 upon 2.46 is the y component. And the moment arm for this is the distance CE, which is 2.4 meters. And this will be clockwise direction, therefore the negative sign. This is the x component of FDF. And the moment arm for this force component would be DC, which is 1 meter. So simplifying this equation will give us FDF equal to minus 6.39 kilonewtons. What is the meaning of minus sign here? It means that our earlier assumption that all the forces in the members are tensile is incorrect. And in reality, the force FDF in the member DF is compressive. Therefore, we can write FDF equal to 6.39 kilonewtons and see denoting it's a compressive force. We now write the moment equation about point D, and the purpose in doing so is that these two forces would get eliminated from our equation because both of them pass through point D, and we'll have only one unknown, FCE, in our equation, in our moment equation. So all these three forces which pass through point D will have zero moment. The moment of FCE would be FCE times 1 meter, which is the moment arm. The moment arm for these two forces would be the distance AC, which is 2.4 meters. So we have this equation, minus 4 times 2.4 plus 1 times 2.4 plus FCE times 1 equal to 0. And that gives us FCE equal to 7.2 kilonewtons. That means the internal force in the member CE is 7.2 kilonewtons tensile. And to find out the force FDE, the magnitude of the force FDE, we sum the forces in x direction. These three forces, which are vertical, would get eliminated, and we'll have to add the x components of all the three forces. This force, we have already found it to be 6.39 kilonewtons, and in fact, its direction is in the reverse direction. Therefore, we shall have minus 6.39, and the x component would be 2.4 over 2.46. So, this is the x component of FDF. We add FCE, which is 7.2 kilonewtons, and we add the x component of FDE, which is FDE times 2.4 upon 2.6, and the sum of all these would be equal to 0, and this will work out to minus 1.047 kilonewtons. The minus sign here indicates that the force is compressive in nature. Therefore, FDE is 1.047 kilonewtons C to denote it's a compressive force. So these are the three internal forces that we were supposed to find out, and that's our answer. Should you have any question or any doubt, please leave them in the comment section and I will respond to them at the earliest. If you like the video, please give your thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.